Let's now bring in Eastern Samar Governor Ben Evardone. Governor, good afternoon, and thank you so much for taking our call, sir.
Good afternoon, and maupay ako no.
Good afternoon. Governor, can you give us a situation update, please, the latest on what's happening?
Well, right now here, thank God the weather is improving, but it's raining again. That's really the situation here. The rain would stop, and then even this morning, the sun briefly shows. But right now, it's raining again here. The weather here is really unpredictable. For the past few days, I think this is the first time that we experienced this kind of weather, very massive and heavy downpour.
Mm-hmm. Can you give us an update, Governor, please, on the casualties, the number of casualties, and even those missing?
Well, so far, there are no reported casualties except one who suffered a heart attack when the floods start to enter their residence. I don't know if we can attribute that to this situation, but we still have seven missing persons here. The five missing persons have disappeared, I think, when we experienced flooding during the Christmas day, and until now they have not yet been found. And the other day, two senior citizens were also reported to be missing because I was informed that they tried to reach the population in the city of Borongan. Until now, we haven't found their location yet.
Mm-hmm. Governor, how many search and rescue operations are ongoing at the moment?
There is an ongoing rescue, search and rescue operation in Borongan, but I think for the five others, we have already given up. I think one of the wreckage of their boat was found in Surigao. Mm-hmm. But the persons were not found in Surigao. So I think we have already given up the search and rescue for the five persons who were missing since Christmas Day.
Mm-hmm. It's been a long time, Governor, that they haven't been found yet. We're seeing pictures and videos earlier from our file that floods have reached roofs of houses. Can you give us areas, please, of the worst hit?
Well, the worst and severely affected areas are the municipalities of Ipapa. That's near Katubi. That's the boundary of Northern Samar. The neighboring town of Arteche, Oras, Dolores, Canavid, those are the, and Maslog, those are the severely affected municipalities. And most of their barangays were submerged with floods. The other areas, well, we also experience but moderate flooding.
Mm-hmm. Are there reports of landslide, Governor?
So far, none, but the link between Western Samar and Eastern Samar is closed. The road is not possible right now. From Katbalogan to Taft, Eastern Samar, it's not possible right now because of the continuous heavy rains. And
since you already mentioned the closed roads, Governor, are there any others, any other national roads or bridges that at the moment cannot be used?
The link between the town of Arteche and Hipapad is not possible right now. But that's why Hipapad is so isolated right now. They have no electricity here. We are having a hard time to reach, to contact them to get the situation there.
Mm-hmm.
Yesterday, I was able to talk to the mayor in the morning. he said that the flood has subsided, but when we contacted the disaster officer of the Hipapad, they told us that the flood has returned in the afternoon.
Are they able to give aid on those affected in Hipapad?
Yes, we were able to preposition some food items, including the DSWD. But the problem right now is the additional relief goods. We cannot access Hipapad right now. That's the problem.
Even on water or air access, Governor, it's hard to reach them?
Water very hard because the current is very strong. And air is very hard also because it's zero visibility. So the only way is by land, really.
How do you communicate with
them? We will wait
Governor?
for the water to subside between the link between Arteche and Hipapad.
How are you able to communicate with Hipapad now, Governor? Are cell sites good at the moment, or are you on two-way radio?
They went down to Arteche by taking a motorcycle.
Okay, that's hopefully the situation there would improve in the next few days, at least for the would be able to reach them for aid distribution. What about situations on evacuation centers, Governor? How many are affected in Eastern Samar?
We have at present around 5,000 families, 5,738 families who evacuated. Some of them are in the evacuation center, some are in schools, some in private houses. We are asking for supply for aqua tubs, aerosol, and other food items for these evacuees right now.
What about potable water and food packs for them also, Governor?
That's what we need also. In fact, these aqua tubs and aerosol are intended to purify water.
That's good enough. Hopefully somebody else would be able to bring help. Some areas have already raised state of calamity. Are there any additional that did raise some for this morning or this afternoon?
Well, we have already declared a state of calamity yesterday, the Sangguniang Panlalawigan, based on the recommendation of the Provincial Disaster Council, which I convened yesterday morning. They already held a special session yesterday afternoon and declared the state of calamity in the entire province of Eastern Samar. This will hasten and expedite the use of calamity funds, of LGUs, even national government agencies, barangays, and shorten the procurement process for goods and services to ensure that the assistance are delivered to the flood victims.
Governor Ben, weather reports are saying that bad weather will still be on up until the at least maybe middle of next week. How are the situation when it comes to budget on the local government units?
That is really a big problem for us, especially that we are just starting the year. I am not sure if the national government has also. I was informed by knowledge that the secretary of DSWD, Secretary Impunay, that they are still awaiting releases from DBM. Because it's a year end, the closing of books. We are also experiencing that problem here in the local.
Are there any operations, at least help from the government, maybe from the Coast Guard or from the PCG, that they'd be able to assist you more with rubber boats at least?
Well, they're in fairness, they're helping us in the repacking and delivery of food assistance to the areas. The AFP, the PNP are very active here.
A couple more questions, Governor Ben, before I let you go. The status of basic commodities, at least on water, electricity, and cellular communication, please.
Well, we have electricity here. We have telecommunications system ongoing. But for the two isolated towns of Maslug and Ipapa, there are no electricity and no communications there.
Okay, and lastly, let's give you a few moments, Governor Ben, to use our airtime for you to at least ask for help, maybe from the national government or for those who are willing to send and extend their aid for you.
Okay, thank you very much for this opportunity. I'm appealing to the national government to continue to support us here, especially our Kabayans, especially the farmers. The farmers are the most severely affected. They have just planted their rice and their plants have been washed out. Mm-hmm. So their problem is to access certified seeds and funds to finance their new replanting, if ever. So we're appealing to the Department of Agriculture, maybe the SWD and DOLE for Tupad and more assistance.
It's more time for us to hunker down because the rains are still expected, Governor. But thank you so much for your time, and hopefully more help will arrive soon. Thank you for your time, Governor.
Maraming salamat po. Thank you.
Have a good day, sir.